Good morning, this is Kasturi Day. Today I am going to discuss the electricity and magnetism chapter question answers, the short and long questions. I was continuing in the last few videos of this question answer series. So let me continue, start with it. First is, why is it possible to recharge a car battery? When actually the car battery is made up of secondary cells and it is known as a lead acid battery. That means it has a plate of lead, another a plate of lead oxide. That is two plates. One is lead, another is of lead oxide. They both are dipped in an acid solution. The acid solution acts as an electrolyte, whereas these two plates, that is one of lead, another is of lead oxide, they behave as cathode and anode. Okay, so electrolysis process goes on. When electric current is passed through, they get recharged. The solution gets ionized and that get recharged. During this process, reverse chemical reaction takes place. That is, when current is passed through, reverse chemical action takes place and the cells and the original chemicals are restored, which is not possible in primary cells because the, this car battery is made up of secondary cells, whereas the the torch battery or other certain devices, they use primary cells where they cannot be recharged. They can be used only once. Okay, compare the behavior of appliances connected to in a parallel circuit and a series circuit. So first difference is that various devices can function independently and any device can be switched on and off without affecting the working of the other devices, as the appliances are connected parallelly. If you switch on or off the particular appliance, it will not affect the other appliances which are connected to it parallelly. Okay, they work independently, they can function independently. Whereas in series, all the devices work simultaneously as the switch is turned on. Devices stop working when the switch is off. Okay, that is, they cannot work independently. They have to be dependent on the other. Now, parallel circuit, if any of the devices is out of order, the other devices continue to work, because it is not affecting the other appliances. Then in series circuit, if any one of the devices go out of order, all the other devices, they stop working. Then third difference between parallel circuit is, each appliances get enough electrical energy, so therefore they work in its full capacity. Whereas in series circuit, same current flows through all the devices, and if one device is not working, it results in a open circuit. Okay, now write the differences between a conductor and an insulator. What is the difference between a conductor and insulator? Conductor is a material which permits the electric current or heat to pass through it. Whereas an insulator, it restricts the electric current or heat to pass through it. Then conductor is electric field. Its electric field exists on the surface but remains zero inside the conductor. Inside the conductor, there is no electric field, but on the surface, there is an electric field. Whereas an insulator, electric field does not exist on the insulator. Any of the electric field is not there. Neither it's on the surface nor it is inside the insulator. Whereas in conductor, magnetic field stores energy. Whereas an insulator, magnetic field does not store any energy. Then conductor, very high conductivity is there in conductor, whereas in insulator, there is a very low conductivity. In conductor, there is very low resistance, whereas in insulator, there is very high resistance. Okay, next we some other differences are also there. In conductor, there are freely moving electrons which help the current to flow through, whereas in insulator, the electrons do not move freely. Then in conductor, for example, iron, aluminium, silver, copper, etc., they are made up of they are conductors, whereas examples of insulator are rubber, wood, paper, etc. for making the conductors are used for making electric wires and conductors, whereas an insulator is electric cables or conductor for supporting electrical equipment, etc. Okay, then why thread cannot be used instead of metal wire to make an electric circuit? Why? Because thread is made up of cotton and cotton is an insulator. Okay, so electricity cannot pass through a thread. And we know that through insulator, current cannot pass through. So, as cotton is an insulator, electricity cannot pass through the thread. Then why? When electricity passes through a wire, it deflects the compass needle. Because when electricity is passing through a wire, it creates a magnetic field around the wire. So, when a compass needle is placed within that field, it shows its deflection. Now, why two terminals of an electric cell should never be connected directly to each other? Because the chemical energy of the cell will get used up quickly and the cell will stop working. Okay. Then, why higher voltage can be obtained by combining a number of cells in a series? Because the value of the individual cells is added. That's why when we combine a number of cells in series, the voltage gets higher and higher because their value is added. Then why symbols are used in an electric circuit? Because in electric circuit, electric circuit is simplified and it's easier to understand and easier to draw. When we use symbols, we cannot draw the whole appliances when there is a small space, or it's very difficult for the actual diagram to draw the appliances. So we use symbols to draw it. And also it's a simplified form and it's easy to understand also. Then differentiate between electromagnet and permanent magnet. See, electromagnet. Electromagnet is the magnetic properties are displayed when the current is passed through it. This is electromagnet. And permanent magnet, magnetic properties exist when the material is magnetized. When the material is magnetized, the magnet properties remain. But when electricity is passing through, then only the magnet shows its the magnetic properties. Okay. Then the strength is adjusted depending upon the amount of flow of current. We can adjust the strength of the electromagnet, how strong will be the electromagnet. Accordingly, we adjust the flow of the electric current. Here, the strength depends upon the nature of the material used in the creation, the material to change into the magnet. The nature of the material shows how much the strength will be there of the magnet. Then, removal of the magnetic properties is temporary. Because as soon as we stop the current flow, the magnet changes into ordinary material. And again, when we start again passing the current, it will get again magnetized. Then once magnetic properties is lost, it becomes useless. Okay. Next is that it requires a continuous supply of electricity to maintain its magnetic field. Okay. And here, permanent magnet does not require a continuous supply of electricity to maintain its magnetic field. Then, electromagnet is usually made of soft materials, whereas a permanent magnet made of hard materials. Like here, it's steel is used, whereas in electromagnet, soft iron is used. The poles, in case of electromagnet, the poles of this kind of magnet can be altered with the flow of current. If we change the flow of the current, then we can alter the magnetic poles. But here, this cannot be changed. Once it is permanently magnetized, then we cannot change its magnetic poles. Okay. Now, which part of the cell acts as a positive terminal? A metal can on one side on one side, metal can on one side, that part of the cell has the positive terminal. That is the metal can. Okay, then how will you test whether a given rod is a magnet or not? For this, we need to take an unidentified rod and a bar magnet. Okay, the steps are that we keep the rod on a wooden table, then we take a bar magnet and bring one end of its poles close to the given material. Okay, now what do we observe? We observe that if the given material is not attracted to the magnet, it means that the given material is made up of a non-magnetic substance. Okay, and if the given material is repelled by the magnet, first is if it is get attracted to the magnet, then it is a not magnetic substance. And if it is repelled, it is definitely a magnet. If the given material is attracted to the magnet, it may either be a magnet of a magnetic material or a magnet that has its opposite pole facing the magnet. Okay, so three cases are there. First is not attracted, then it is made of non-magnetic substance. Second, if it is repelled, then it is definitely a magnet. Third, if it is getting attracted to the magnet, then it is either it's a magnetic material or it is the opposite pole of the magnet. Okay. Next, now bring the other poles of the magnet near the same end of the given material. If it is again attracted to the material, then it means that the given material is not a magnet, it is a magnetic substance. Whereas if it is repelled by the magnet, then it is definitely a magnet. So conclusion is that repulsion is the surest test of magnetism. Okay. So, I'll stop here. I'll continue with the rest of the chapter, question answers series, in the next video. Please go through them. And if you have any doubt, please do write in the comment box. And you can also give suggestions how to improve my videos so that I can produce you some more interesting videos. And if you like the video, press the like button. That can help me to produce you good videos. And if you have not subscribed yet or you are a new viewer to my channel, please do subscribe to get the notification of my next video. Thank you.